Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Elegant Corner. In this video, we'll see what are the parts of the throttle station. See, we all know that the throttle station is one of the most important equipment in the civil engineering point of view, where it was used in the construction part for the measurements of angles, to measurement vertical angle, horizontal angle, and to compute the area or to compute the distance between the two remote sensor points and all. We used to use the throttle station widely in the construction. Now in this video, we'll see what are the various parts in the throttle station. Before starting the video, if you are new to the channel, please do subscribe our channel Elegant Corner and click the bell icon. You will definitely get the notification after posting the video. Now we'll see what are the various parts in the throttle station. In this video, we'll see the what are the various parts without arranging this throttle station upon the trapezoid. See, because to know the parts in this video, just we are showing this instrument and I will show you the what are the various parts in the throttle station, how to pronounce the various parts and what is the use of the various parts. See, if you are in the field, while in the construction point of view or to compute the points and angles, there we used to use the trapezoid, that is nothing but the stand which was placed below the throttle station, which consists of the three legs, and to the opposite we used to use a prism pole. With the help of the prism pole, the reflections will be calculated and the measurements will be taken. So in this video, we'll see just what are the various parts in the throttle station. Now we'll start from the bottom part to the head of the throttle station. We'll see what are the various step by step, what are the various parts in the throttle station. See here, the bottom, this thing we used to call it as tri-batch. The bottom thing we used to call it as tri-batch, where it consists of base plate, and above the base plate we used to have this leveling head. The thing, this part we used to call it as leveling head. This leveling head consists of three screws here. See, these are the three screws. All three corners we used to have the three screws. The use of the three screws are nothing but to leveling purpose. While we used to take the readings or to centralize the throttle station, we used to arrange the screws. With the help of the screws, we used to make the leveling accurately without any errors, so that we'll make the compute the distance between the two points or to take the angles and all. We used to initiate the work. So with the help of this 3-foot screws, we used to initiate the work. Next coming aspect, this thing, this display, we used to call it as input set, where we used to have the display and the keyboard, where we used to initiate, that is nothing but where we used to give the commands to this throttle station. By the help of the keyboard, we used to give the commands to this display or to this throttle station. All the work will be carried out and the things will be displayed here. What are the things we are carrying out, which type of work, what are the various points, coordinates, what are the various points and all, through this display we used to see. And coming to this part, we can see a bubble tube here. This is a bubble tube where we can see an accuracy of the throttle station, in the leveling, without any errors and all. We used to see with the help of this bubble tube, we used to arrange it properly. By changing the legs of the tripod, where we can see the centralize this bubble tube. Next coming aspect is about this horizontal clamp screw and horizontal tangent screw. This thing, this black thing here, this is horizontal clamp screw and this thing horizontal tangent screw. The first use of this horizontal tangent screw is to lock the this throttle station. For example, see here, if you lock the throttle station like this, you can't move the horizontal change in this throttle station. If you release this thing, the throttle station can move horizontally freely like this. So with the help of this horizontal tangent screw, we used to lock the throttle station. The horizontal movements will be locked like this. And in the after locking, this horizontal clamp screw is about a slight adjustment. For example, if you are accurately taking any particular any measurement or any angle or any point distance, if you lock this throttle station and if you are recording the data with this telescope, you can lock it. But if you want to make a slight correction and all, you just adjust. If you see, if you are at the field, you can experience a slight change in the alignment in the horizontal thing in this throttle station. If you like change this horizontal clamp screw, you can see a slight movement. See here, you can notice, just I'm keeping my hand, you can see the slight movement. If you are in the field, you can easily experience this movement. And this is about the horizontal clamp screw and horizontal tangent screw. Now, next we will see about this, we'll somewhat shift to the upper part of the throttle station. If you see here, this is a battery. This is a battery for the throttle station, where it gives the power to this throttle station working and to do the readings or to initiate the work, and up to the end mark, with the help of the battery, we'll carry out all the things. The power supply will be given. This battery, by using this battery power, this throttle station will be working. Next coming aspect, at this telescope point, here we still have the same as a vertical horizontal clamp screw and the horizontal tangent screw. We used to have the vertical clamp screw and vertical tangent screw. The same impact, the same work will be carried out, somewhat differentiated. This is about the horizontal movement. This horizontal clamp screw and horizontal tangent screw will be used. And for this vertical movement for this telescope, this vertical clamp screw and vertical tangent screw will be used. For example, if you are taking any like elevations or any angles and all, you will fix it. This is the eyepiece, we'll fix it and we'll take the reading from the eyepiece. So then we used to lock this vertical tangent screw, we used to lock so that we won't have any movement in this telescope. Okay, in this case also, for any slight adjustments and all, from by the help of the vertical clamp screw here, we used to move it, so then the telescope alignment will change minutely. If you are in the field, you can experience this movement also. So see here, I will show you the slight change in, by changing this vertical clamp screw. See, there will be the change in the telescope. This is about the vertical clamp screw and vertical tangent screw. Next, coming to this telescope aspect, this is a telescope. From this we used to sight the point where from the prism pole we used to take the readings and all. So this is an eyepiece. This is an eyepiece where through this we used to see the points here from the other side, and this will be the object piece. This screw will be used for the focus screw will be used for the zoom in and zoom out. This focus screw is used for the zoom in and zoom out for the object. While we are sighting from this eyepiece, this thing will be used to zoom in and zoom out. Okay, in this eyepiece, we used to have the screw, focus screw. We used to adjust it because we used to have the crosshair inside. If you experience from sightation, we can see the crosshair inside. So we need to adjust the crosshair properly, and from the object glass the things will be recorded, and we need to see from the eyepiece, and we need to adjust this focus screw, zoom in and zoom out. This is about the telescope in this throttle station. If you release this vertical clamp and vertical clamp screw and vertical tangent screw, the movement of the telescope will be somewhat very smooth, and you can take down the point where you are recording, and then you need to lock the vertical screws. Next, coming to the next part of the throttle station, this is a handle for the throttle station. With the help of the handle, we can lift the throttle station and take to some other position, or to carry it from one place to another place. This is nothing but the optical sight. This is nothing but the optical sight. The topmost thing here is nothing but the optical sight. From the optical sight, this thing, the laser rays will be shooted on the particular object. See, the particular object in the other position is nothing but this prismatic pole. This prism pole, from the prism pole and all, this rays will be reflected to the prism, and from the prism again it will be reflected back, so that the work will be carried out in between this optical sight and to this prismatic pole. This is nothing but the prism pole, where we used to have bubble tube also in this prism pole, and we used to make it in a good alignment, and through which we will carry out this work. Last but not the least, this is nothing but the vertical plummet, which is used for the centering. While this arrangement of this throttle station was based upon the like tripod angle. By the use of the vertical plummet, we used to make the centering. And here, the one of the foremost important thing, after carrying out all this work and all, we can transfer the data from this throttle station to the computer by the using this port, USB port here. So from this USB port, see here, we can transfer the things to the computer. These are the various parts in the throttle station. We have discussed the what are the various parts and what are the uses of the various parts in the throttle station. Now we'll see like a free movement in the throttle station.